Humanity has been anticipating the return of astronauts to lunar soil for more than 5 decades. NASA Artemis III mission, scheduled for 2027 in partnership with SpaceX Starship Human Landing System, aspires to make that vision a reality. However, Starship HLS is currently experiencing significant delays and technical difficulties. As NASA's bold Artemis timeline moves forward, the uncertainty is growing. At the same time, China is rapidly advancing its aspirations for lunar exploration. Could it be possible for them to set foot on the moon before the United States? Let's discuss more in today's episode of NR Studio. Amid the increasing focus on Blue Origin's NS-31 flight, it's often overlooked that NASA is diligently working against the clock to prepare for Artemis II, the first crewed mission of the Artemis program, scheduled to launch around this time next year. At Kennedy Space Center in Florida, the Space Launch System rocket is currently undergoing assembly inside the famed Vehicle Assembly Building, with teams working around the clock to integrate the final components. NASA has clearly shifted its focus and momentum to ensuring the Artemis II launch is on time. At the same time, anxiety is starting to creep into aspects of SpaceX mission. They have successfully secured a multi-billion-dollar contract to provide the human landing system for Artemis III. Yet so far, there has been no communication at all. There has been no official announcement regarding the Starship HLS. There have been no new developments regarding the crucial orbital propellant depot. As time passes, anxiety among the public is starting to grow. Even the most ardent SpaceX fans find themselves pondering the reasons behind the silence. Is everything going according to plan, or are there unspoken things going on? So far, SpaceX Progress in supporting NASA Artemis missions has not lived up to anticipated expectations. They have conducted 8 test flights. However, the results have been less than stellar. Earlier this year, the simultaneous explosions of Starship Flights 7 and 8 shattered confidence, disappointing not only NASA but also key stakeholders like the Department of Defense and investors. However, these constraints have their advantages. Over the course of its multiple flights, SpaceX has collected a wealth of invaluable data, particularly regarding the retrieval of superheavy thrusters utilizing the blowpipe mechanism and improvements to the Starship design. For example, after overheating damage to the alt cowl during Flight 1, SpaceX reinforced it with heat-resistant materials and modified the re-entry angle to reduce thermal stress. Similarly, complications arising from the shedding of heat shield tiles during Flights 3 and 5 prompted improvements to the quality of the tiles and the development of more robust installation techniques for future missions. In light of the 2 recent explosions, SpaceX has identified a significant issue that must be addressed for future missions: harmonic resonance. This phenomenon occurs when vibrations accumulate inappropriately, putting undue stress on the propulsion system hardware. The data collected to date has laid a solid foundation for Starship version 2 upgrades. SpaceX is set to advance testing of its new Raptor 3 engines in upcoming flights. After collecting enough data from 5 to 10 additional test flights, SpaceX plans to introduce Starship version 3, which will be modified to serve as a tanker and orbital refueling depot variant, thereby supporting Artemis 3. Rest assured, Elon Musk and SpaceX have a comprehensive understanding of their goals and are well aware of their progress. Check out the commendable progress they have made so far to recognize their trajectory toward success. To begin, let's discuss the upgrades at Starbase. There has been talk that Pad B could be engineered for mobility, allowing SpaceX to efficiently perform post-launch repairs or replacements. This would help in achieving their ambitious goal of conducting 1 Starship launch per day, or perhaps at a faster rate. Indeed, the concept is becoming increasingly logical. A puzzling component was recently observed en route to Pad B, and the alignment of its bolt holes matches the mounting points identified at the construction site. It appears that SpaceX is in the process of installing the launch cradle legs below the pad. This configuration confirms its current fixed structure. However, given that it is bolted together, there is still flexibility to disassemble it for future upgrades or maintenance. On Pad B, the flame deflector has been successfully installed within the trench, and the team is currently engaged in installing the piping for the extensive water deluge system. You may have noticed those rather large green pipes. They are responsible for supplying the large volumes of water needed to effectively cool the pad and reduce the extreme heat and pressure generated during launch. The water system is divided into 2 distinct components. One assembly of five tanks supplies a spray system that generously drenches the pad from above, while another assembly of four much larger tanks pours water directly into the fire trench. SpaceX does need a lot of water, as the activation of the 33 Raptor engines is not just a spectacle of noise and fire. It also shakes the surrounding foundations. The water serves to dampen unwanted noise and maintain the integrity of the pit, preventing it from melting. If construction goes according to schedule, Pad B is expected to be operational by the end of the year, allowing SpaceX to complete its remaining 23 flights by 2026. Furthermore, the Raptor 3 vacuum engine was seen at the McGregor test facility on April 2nd, indicating that SpaceX is ramping up preparations for the Starship test flight due later this year. Near the Mega Bay, one can see an interesting nose cone that sits unobtrusively within the confines of the rocket park. Originally part of the now decommissioned Ship 22, the nose cone has now been repurposed as an early mock-up of the HLS to aid SpaceX in the design and planning of the lander's interior configuration. Now let's turn our attention to another encouraging indication. NASA has officially announced that the Human Landing System, HLS Elevator System Test, has been completed in late 2023. NASA astronauts Nicole Mann and Doug Wheelock recently took part in a mini elevator model test for SpaceX Starship manned landing system, which is scheduled to be used on NASA Artemis 3 and 4 future lunar missions. In April 2024, NASA astronauts continued to engage in hardware testing related to the Starship HLS. Images showed astronauts wearing pressurized suits, positioned inside a replica of the Starship HLS, likely near the entrance or elevator section. This is a significant signal that SpaceX remains involved in the project. While their activities may seem quiet, they are clearly moving forward diligently to secure the continuity of the Artemis mission. This vehicle will facilitate humanity's first return to the moon since 1972, marking a monumental milestone this century. While all of the test flights conducted so far have only reached the LEO stage, none have been specifically engineered to function as lunar landers. It is anticipated that a prototype will be ready for that mission soon. To date, most of our insight into the HLS has come from interior and exterior mockups. These mockups highlight significant design differences. Unlike the orbiting Starship, the Human Landing System, HLS, will not require a heat shield or a cowling, given the moon's lack of atmosphere. Instead, it will be equipped with landing legs, a critical feature for lunar landings. It will use special Raptor engines designed specifically for lunar landings, featuring modified thrust levels to reduce disturbances caused by lunar dust. A major hurdle facing SpaceX lies in the fact that Artemis requires more than just the Human Landing System, or HLS. In addition to the lander, SpaceX must also advance the development of the Starship tanker and build an orbital refueling depot. The HLS is heavy, as it will carry additional fuel, allowing it to reach lunar orbit, pick up astronauts, ensure a safe landing, and facilitate return to orbit. The tanker will be based on the Starship version 3 design, albeit without the cowling and thermal protection systems. In contrast, the fuel tanker variant will require both and will be engineered for rapid reusability. To increase fuel capacity, SpaceX is considering several strategies. One potential solution is to incorporate a substantial additional tank into the payload section or to lengthen the primary tank to optimize internal space utilization. We anticipated the launch of these variants to coincide with HLS, but Elon Musk has unexpectedly changed our expectations. In a statement made in early March, he indicated that there is a high probability that Starship could be fully reusable within this year. Starship would be fully and rapidly re-energized, accompanied by orbital refueling, likely next year. This means that, with Artemis III scheduled for 2027, the initial launch of these two variants could be the first breakthrough, orbital refueling. In short, SpaceX is ramping up its initiatives at Starbase in Texas, as well as at its headquarters in Florida. They are upgrading launch infrastructure and developing new production facilities at Pad A and Pad B. Once the facility is fully operational, we can expect substantial improvements in testing capabilities. There is still a possibility of a fully functional human landing system, HLS, by the time Artemis III launches, depending on SpaceX's ability to maintain its current momentum in completing the design, testing, and refinement of the lunar lander by the end of 2027. If delays continue, China could gain a competitive advantage, given its strong determination to surpass the United States. And this time, it's a bold one. China is accelerating its lunar landing schedule by an impressive 1 year. Rather than delaying its lunar ambitions until 2030, it is proactively moving up its schedule to achieve a lunar landing in 2029 with the Long March 10th rocket. Herein lies the crucial twist, the Long March 10th. A modified variant will be used to launch a next-generation crewed spacecraft to the Tiangong Space Station in low Earth orbit. With an impressive height of 67 meters and a diameter of 5 meters, this rocket is a remarkable engineering feat. It has the capacity to lift 1,200 kilograms into the cosmos. The rocket is equipped with a booster recovery system similar to SpaceX Starship. But their ambitions don't end there. The lunar iteration of the Long March 10th will be an impressive three-stage rocket, reaching a height of 92 meters. The system has the capacity to deliver 27 tons to a translunar injection orbit, putting it on par with NASA SLS Block 1. The rocket itself has the potential to be partially reusable. This is where things get really concerning. China's bold initiative involves deploying not one but two Long March 10th rockets. These spacecraft will facilitate the transportation of astronauts to the moon and back, with Mengzhou serving as the crew module and Lanyu acting as the lunar lander, rendezvousing in lunar orbit. The astronauts will then journey to Lanyu, make a landing on the lunar surface, and remain there for 6 hours before reuniting with their third crew in orbit, mirroring the historic Apollo missions with remarkable precision. What's their timeline, you ask? The first launch is anticipated in 2026. China successfully conducted a static fire test in June 2002, with the launch pad expected to be fully operational by 2025. This is no mere incremental effort. It is a significant construction effort, utilizing advanced technology and advancing at an astonishing pace. China is advancing at an unprecedented pace, surpassing all expectations. China's ambitions go beyond simply landing astronauts. They are strategizing for a sustained presence. From 2033 to 2035, there are plans to build a nuclear fusion power plant on the lunar surface. On April 23rd, a top Chinese space official confirmed this ambitious initiative. While NASA aspires to deploy a comparable system by the early 2030s, China is proactively laying the groundwork, determined in its ambition to lead the way in the pursuit of space-based energy. The question at hand is thus unambiguous. Can the United States keep up the pace? This competition is no longer a distant concern. China is fully committed, devoting all available resources to securing victory in this contest. If America shows any hesitation, the next flag raised on the moon may not be red, white, and blue. But the narrative is far from over. NASA continues to build on the legacy of Apollo, while SpaceX, through its bold vision and relentless ambition, is redefining the boundaries of what is possible. Time is of the essence, but the race remains within reach. The trajectory to the moon remains within reach. It now depends on the level of desire each party has. That's it for today's episode. See you in the next one, and thank you for your support.